Good evening, everybody, and welcome to the Brookfield Board of Selectmen's meeting for December 13th. Ask everyone to please rise for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you, everyone. If I could ask everyone to please remain standing. Brookfield has lost a, in my opinion, a hero. His wake was actually today, his funeral is tomorrow. I would ask everyone to please observe a moment of silence for Mr. Frank Leo. Frank Leo? Thank you, everyone. All right, first item is approval of warrants. I'll entertain a motion to approve the account payable warrant for 11:30, withholding warrant for 11:03, withholding warrant for 11:30, expense warrant for 12:06, payroll warrant for 12:06, expense warrant for 12:13.
I will make that motion.
Second.
Any discussion?
No.
All in favor?
Aye.
Entertain a motion to approve the month end for the Brookfield Fire Department.
I will make that motion.
Second.
Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
There are no announcements. Anybody, well, do you guys have any announcements?
No.
Anybody wish to address the board this evening?
Something that should be on the agenda.
Oh, you're on the agenda.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
Mr. Holcraft, welcome.
Good evening.
Evening, sir.
Last night we met with the town accountant, the advisory board, and it went very, very well. All the doors that were closed are all open, and there's a lot more open now. Everybody felt very good when we ended the meeting, so I think she's going to help us with the spreadsheet, and I think it's going to go very, very good. So
good.
We had a good discussion about different things, and we can talk to her, and she's going to talk to us, and we're all on the same page of trying to get it right. So thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Anybody else wish to address the board this evening? Right. Item number one is the town account review. Carrie, if we could have you come on up, take the hot seat. Welcome, ma'am.
Hello.
If you could just state your name and position for everyone that's listening out there.
Carrie Polakowski, town accountant.
Welcome, ma'am. I know in today's world of searching for a word, but I'm not going to say anything.
In today's world.
In today's world, period. I know we want rubrics and whatnot, and I'm not a big rubric fan. I'm kind of a black and white guy. If you're doing a great job, you stay with the town of Brookfield. If you're doing a lousy job, we thank you for your 3 months of service, and we find somebody else.
So which way are we going?
me personally, I'll start off the discussion. I'm very pleased.
Yeah.
I've heard nothing but good things. Everything's balancing. We're good to have the chairman of the advisory committee come up and sing your praises. I think it's huge for this town. And it's about time that, and we talk about open doors and working with the advisory committee. I served on the advisory committee. It was tough. It was really tough getting answers to questions that we needed answers for to provide for the town. So I'm good with you.
Okay.
Thank you, ma'am. Linda?
I am too. Carrie has done an outstanding job for the town so far, and as the old saying goes, when we hired her, she hit the ground and she was running. And she's been doing excellent, and she's got rave reviews from all of the employees. They're all they all compliment you on the job that you're doing.
And with that, I forgot to read, but I'll let Linda read from a town employee.
We have one here. I have that too. I'll read it in a minute if you want.
Mm-hmm.
And she's done wonderful. I mean, she's working on the, she's adapted well to VADAR. And also she's been working on the gateway system, which is from the Department of Revenue when you set the tax rate. She's willing, she's going to go to school in March, she told me, and she's just doing outstanding things. And I also would like to, at this time, to compliment Joan Walker, who stepped in right off when we needed a town accountant, and she's been with Carrie for a while. She's been a big help, and anytime Carrie needs any questions, she's right here to help Carrie out. And she's adapting to very good, and you know, she's working, she's only required to work 20 hours a week, but some weeks she's been working 30 hours, and she always hasn't put in for 30 hours worth of work, but I feel if she's doing that, she should. So, that's what I'd like to say, so keep on going.
And what do we need to be doing differently?
What do you need to be doing differently?
What do we need to be thinking about differently?
Off the top of my head, nothing major. I think that we've, over the last several months, we have increased communication between all the departments, and I think that's a plus. Getting paperwork moved faster, mm-hmm. And processed more quickly so that vendors are paid more quickly. That's, I think, has already stepped in the right direction. And other than that, I mean, I do have some ideas that could, you know, benefit the town in the long run, but that's, we'll talk about that. And but I think the town in general has made great strides in moving towards the future as far as technology and, basically technology. There's a lot more room to go, mm-hmm. but I think that's that's a benefit that I have coming from, you know, outside of the municipal society. I think I tend to think a little bit more outside the box than most. So we'll be talking a lot about technology.
That's good.
Yeah.
Thank you.
If you would allow me this time, I'd like to read. This is from an employee of the town. To the Board of Selectmen, I understand that our town accountant, Carrie Polakowski, is on the agenda for the next selectmen's meeting for her three-month review. I am writing to acknowledge that, in my opinion, Carrie has done an outstanding job in her first 3 months. Carrie works great with everyone in this office. I am thankful we have had such a good town accountant. One of the things Carrie does is send out weekly reports on expense balances, which is very helpful. And he also says that Joan Walker was very helpful in getting us moving in the right direction, and that was signed by Michael Seary, town clerk.
Thank you.
So that's from that was from Mike, and
I'm
sure that the rest of the employees feel the same way.
They've made me feel very welcome. That's for sure.
Doesn't that help?
It does.
That's nice.
It does.
I know, and they're all happy. Everybody's getting along good, and it's really nice to see that.
Yeah.
You know why? Because work's being done.
Yeah, work is being done. Everybody and everybody's communicating well, and it is. It's really working well, and I'm very happy.
Okay, great. Thank you.
So my personality, the record will reflect that you are welcome. Right.
Thank you.
No, thank you.
Could I maybe say something else?
Say whatever you'd like.
Okay. I would like to make a motion. If there's money in the budget, I think I would like to give Carrie a dollar raise in pay.
Second.
Discussion. I think this is a bad time to do it. When we did the interview, there was a knowledge of the workload, and then it tapering back out. To do this just arbitrarily, I think, flies in the face of all our town employees. I'd argue not to do this.
Well, we have done it before with new employees. I mean, after we've given them their three-month review.
And I've always argued against it, and I would stand my ground on this. It's not proper management.
Mr. Snyder, do you have a comment?
I think we might need to wait for spring.
Oh.
Would be my
All right. We'll wait till the spring. But if it was my choice, yeah,
that's where the burden lies. In my opinion, is a discussion with the advisory committee and then the town physically approving it.
Okay.
And I think it's worthwhile bringing it forward.
We will bring that
absolutely
forward.
It's just the time.
Yes. Okay.
And then hopefully we did discuss that the workload would be kind of tough at the beginning.
It is.
And you are finding your way.
Yep.
And hopefully those hours will taper off. And
yeah, there's a lot going on with the year end and the tax rate and things like that. So it should taper off, I think, after the first of the year.
When we talked today, didn't you also say you're pretty much close to closing out the year and you were just waiting for the school?
Yes. Well, no, I'm not waiting for the school. Oh. They're waiting for me.
Oh, they're waiting for you. Okay.
They have a lot of accounts that need to be balanced, mm-hmm. and I'm one of those people I can't let 2 cents slide. So, and there are some that are off, you know, a couple of dollars here and there, and I...
We don't want to let 2 cents slide in any department.
No. No. And I need to find everything, and before I put my stamp on it as final, I want to make sure it's all done.
Okay. All right, so for formality, we do have a motion on the floor. Again, I urge everyone to vote no through discussion. So all in favor? Opposed?
No.
No. Unanimous. Thank you. Any questions for us?
Nope.
Thank you very much, ma'am.
Thank you. Right, so thank I guess you. You're with us. Congratulations, Karen.
Item number 2, signing alcohol and common vic class 2 licenses. Mm-hmm. This requires a signature from all 3, one at a time. I will enter in all the apps are in completion with checks. I will entertain a motion to accept restaurant common vic to Clam Box, 53 South Maple.
Do you want to do them all together?
You want to do them all together?
Yeah.
Okay, so this is alcohol for, I just need a list at the end of the day.
Okay.
Alcohol, common vic for Clam Box. Alcohol for Bay Path Spirits. Retail package, alcohol for Bay Path Spirits. Common vic for Bay Path Spirits. Common vic for Central Package. Alcohol for common package. Brookfield Rod and Gun, Common Vic and Alcohol, Dollar General, Common Vic, Cumberland Farms, Common Vic, Congressional Church, Common Vic, Tip Top, Common Vic, Doing Businesses, B&R Coachworks, used car dealer,
yeah,
class 2.
One
packet with their check. So that's it. So I'll entertain a motion for all of those.
I'll make that motion.
No, second it.
Any discussion?
No.
I probably should recuse on the Congregational Church.
I think we're good.
No, okay. You're good?
But that's your call.
All right. Yeah. Then I'll just go along with it.
All in favor?
Aye. Aye.
All right. Class, can you just shoot those back to me one
sure.
at a time as you sign them so I can take notes of what we did? If you can just put them in a pile right there. Thank you, sir.
Oh,
no, Linda's got to go to Clarence first.
Yep. I get the pile on.
Okay.
No, I've done that one.
Oh, okay.
So that's going to be the return pile.
Thank you, man. Excuse me. Reach over here.
You're done, yeah. I'd reach down, but it would be it. The thing is.
that's the last one.
Yep. No, that's not it.
Okay.
I think that just goes to show that we do have businesses in the town of Brookfield. Thank you, everyone. Item number three is a community development discussion. I did read this, Linda. Thank you very much. My only question...
I have the
Oh.
Mine is the
Compact. Okay, so community development, excuse me. So Clarence?
Nope, Chris.
Chris?
Chris Duffy.
He wants to speak to it as opposed to Mr. Snyder? Yeah. Welcome, sir. Floor is yours.
I'm just a supportive kind of guy on this particular subject.
Come and join us. Thank you, sir. If you could just state your name and position for...
Certainly. So thank you for the board for having me up here this evening. My name is Christopher Dunphy. I'm a planner with the Pioneer Valley Planning Commission. I'm here to discuss with the board essentially three separate and distinct topics. Two of them are informational in nature, and one of them, one of the items will actually require some level of approval from the Board of Selectmen. So, I was sitting there thinking, I think it's been about 2 years since
I last... Has it been that long?
Yeah, I think so, actually. And at
I was
going to
say a year.
At that time, I was pitching a grant that you take be a part of with the towns of Warren and North Brookfield, and that was funded.
Yeah.
And Warren is the lead community for that grant. But for Brookfield, it provided for some housing rehabilitation services to area residents here in Brookfield, and also it provided funds for a planning study to hire a professional consultant to see if not we can maybe put a plan together to improve services for area seniors and maybe even look at a future site for seniors. So, and we'll get back to that in a minute. Okay, the second item is really the more pressing item for tonight, and that's the community development strategy. To be a part of these community development block grants, periodically the town has to meet in a formal public meeting and discuss what are some of the priorities within the community and sort of adopt what we call community development strategy. So I think I've given you what the guidelines are. I've handed it off in this one-page document. These are the guidelines for the community development strategy, and here is the draft strategy here. This essentially is not a lot different than what was used in the grant application a couple years ago. It sort of outlines some of the general priorities in a more general nature for the community, as well as some very specific projects that, you know, if the funding were to become available, these were things that you'd like to address. The DHCD, as part of this block grant application process, they like to see communities have these discussed, so it doesn't appear like projects are coming out of thin air when you're actually asking for grant money to fund them. Okay?
So Clarence, have you looked at the 2013 plan?
I haven't. There was a meeting in a group while I was away last week. I met with Chris.
Do you know if it's changed dramatically?
It has not changed dramatically. In this copy that I've given you here, it might be hard to make it out, but you'll see most of the font is pretty dark, but where the font is a little bit lighter. And I've given you, I don't know what you're looking at, but I gave you new copies.
Is it 2013?
I don't think Stephen has that
Yeah, this one.
Mine's a little faded.
There you go, there you go. So within that document, you can see the font that is dark is from the old community development strategy. And the lighter font are some of the changes. And these changes, Lucinda largely took control to update this to account for some new information that has become available to the town. And get rid of information that is no longer relevant. So, and these were discussed with the Community Development Advisory Committee. We have a couple members with us here tonight. And we feel it, by and large, addresses most of the needs and priorities of Brookfield. I would just say that you don't have to act on this tonight. What I typically do with other communities is I present it. And I'm just going to quickly read out some of these things so it's on record as being discussed in public. And then you can keep comment period open, say, for maybe approximately a month, and then reconvene in sometime early January to adopt it. That would be my recommendation.
So you don't need an adoption tonight? Because skimming through it, I'm familiar with the old one. Mm-hmm. The changes are basically made to what's happened in town. And just revamping it.
Okay, so if you're satisfied...
The only reason why I'm satisfied is because of the people that worked on it.
Okay. Yes. So just so I'm addressing it in public, some of the general priorities that we discussed with the Community Development Advisory Committee include housing and trying to continue to improve your housing conditions and making opportunities available for residents that qualify for assistance. We know that there's issues with sewers and septic in town because you have no municipal sewer, and consequently there is a need to continually address the need to improve septic systems. Same thing with potable water. You have an older system, and primarily in the center. For those that aren't on the system, you know, perhaps there's a need for well improvements, and as well as improving the municipal system that's in place. Senior services, presently there is no dedicated facility for seniors. They use, you know, in part some of this facility here, as well as a local nearby church. And if funding were to become available, that is an area, a priority area that it could be addressed. Just revitalization within the center of this community is an issue. Police station was on this list, but it's something that has been addressed by the town, so that has consequently been removed from the list. Continue to look at brownfields. Brownfields are, I won't say contaminated, but what the EPA likes to say is properties that people think might be contaminated. So if people think a property is contaminated, it's hard to convince someone to invest in that property and redevelop it.
I'll say it. We have contaminated properties.
Yeah, they exist, but I just want people, it's not necessarily contaminated. It could be properties that people think are. And sometimes EPA brownfield funds can be made available to actually look at it and assess it. And in some instances, it's determined that it's not nearly as contaminated as people thought. So... that's an issue. The public library, the improvements could be happen there. General planning, the cemetery, the youth and community center, preserving heritage landscapes, Bannister Common and Mall, preservation in general. There's an agricultural commission looking to assist in those areas. The mobile home park, Sawmill Pond Dam, Lakeside Condominium Campground, interesting area I visited a couple times over the last few months, and I think that might be ripe for some sort of assistance in the future, maybe even brownfield assistance.
We got 1 million pounds less material on the site today than we had a couple of weeks ago or a couple of months ago.
So, in essence, these are some of the priorities that were discussed with the Community Development Advisory Committee. It's part of the strategy, and again, the strategy is a tool that we just use as part of a grant application. It's not scored, but it's just to show the grant readers that, you know, some of these priorities are continually talked about in the public and are recognized by the communities as issues of concern.
And I'm ready to entertain a motion to accept and approve the community development strategy for Brookfield for fiscal year 2017 to 19.
I will make that motion.
I'll second it.
Any discussion?
The only one question I have, so we're just applying for this by Brookfield itself. We're not going with another community.
That's a separate issue. I'd like to finalize discussion on the community development strategy, and then we can talk about the actual grant moving forward.
Okay.
So when the minutes are actually, I extract the minutes, I'd like the section regarding the strategy to stand out as its own separate discussion. So.
And what this is a laundry list. That we get to pick and choose, basically, because what you'll have is you'll have some folks saying there's grant funding in a particular direction. You then have that, and you combine that with your strategy to decide whether or not that's something that you want to move forward with, or if there are other priorities that you don't necessarily want to take that grant or work that grant idea, you'd work another grant.
Mm-hmm.
This could provide funding for the idea of the compact stuff, the additional stuff.
Incidentally, I'd like it on record that Andrew Lowe, a former colleague at the Pioneer Valley Planning Commission, he is collaborating with me on various initiatives with the town of Brookfield. He is now a planner with the Central Mass Regional Planning Commission, and the Central Mass Regional Planning Commission and the Pioneer Valley Planning Commission have developed a memorandum of understanding that we'd work cooperatively to help a lot of these towns that sort of sit between both the RPAs. So I think that's a positive thing for this community, and moving forward, Andrew and I will continue to collaborate together.
What was the last name again?
Andrew Lowe, L-O-E-W.
He's working with Cindy on the Finney, as the example.
All right. Any other questions, comments, concerns?
So that's community development strategy. Okay. Thank you, committee.
Do we take a vote?
No. You need
all
to.
In favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Thank you. Thank you, sir.
Great. Now, I'd briefly like to talk about the upcoming grant application. Those are some of the general guidelines. No action tonight. This is all just discussion. We're in the preliminary stages of trying to flush out what might be the best approach for the town of Brookfield to apply for CDBG funding with a grant application due date of March 10th. It's Friday, March 10th. So in past years, there were a number of different competitive elements associated with the grant applications. You'd get bonus points for regionalizing, which you did.
Yeah.
You get bonus points for putting together multiple projects, which you did. And there were four competitive questions. A lot of this for this particular funding year has been dispensed with by the state. I don't know for whatever reasons, but they wanted to take a new approach. So communities do not have to regionalize there's no incentive or either way for regionalizing. You do not have to put together multiple projects to score competitively. And the other factor, the most important factor that's changed in past years, the state sort of categorized communities by need, demographic need charts. And they classified communities as either being a CDF1 community, presumably with high needs by the scoring matrix that they use, or a CDF2 community, presumably communities with lower needs based on the matrix that they use. Being a CDF1 allowed you to apply every year, and there was a far greater pot of money available for the CDF1 communities. CDF2 communities could only get assistance every other year. It was far more competitive, and the amounts of money available for those CDF2 communities was paltry. It was only like $2.5 million available statewide. So they would typically only fund, two or three grants out of that pool. But for this year, this upcoming grant, they dispensed with having the separations, trying to invite in more applicants throughout the state, presumably. Which is a good thing, good for Brookfield, in that now you're on the competitive, your competitive nature has risen greatly. So you can apply on your own.
Yeah, that was my question.
Yep, you can apply on your own if you choose to. And you could also, in addition to applying on your own, you could be a part of a regional if you wanted. So there's a number of things that we've been kicking around with the Community Development Advisory Committee. Certainly, we on the committee recognize housing rehab as a remaining a priority for the town. There's a lot of people. We continue to get calls for assistance. We know that there's failed septics out there, and we think that's a pretty good program, and people are taking advantage of it, and we have a wait list for it. It was also mentioned that you have some infrastructure projects that have been designed. In other words, they're shovel ready, but we haven't been able to find funding to get them off the ground. So I think it was Hayden Street, I believe, was one of the ones kicked around as a possible project in this application. We also, as you know, we funded the planning study to look at senior services in town. And the town hired an architecture firm, Catlin and Petrovic Architects, and they've been working with the committee to look at the services and see if not there's a way to move forward with, first improving the services to the seniors, and secondly, maybe finding a facility that can be centralized as a senior center. And we've looked at other parcels in town, but what's jumping out as the most likely place to rehabilitate for a senior center is the basement here in this town hall. So consequently, the planning study is leaning towards recommending a design project to rehabilitate the basement of this town hall to become a senior center, which is an eligible CDBG activity. So those are a few of the things that have been discussed as part of the next grant application due on March 10th. Again, to be developed by CMRPC with PVPC's assistance. So I don't know if there's discussion or questions on those.
I think it's excellent.
You can get up to $800,000 for this grant if successful. Some of the factors that determine a competitiveness in the past remain, but they're less impactful. So if it's written really good, there was a minor thing that we just found out the rules last week, by the way, and we're still kind of going through them.
Is it fully funded or matching?
I'm sorry.
Is it
They included, which is new for this particular funding. They have some sort of leveraging aspect in the grant. They're not insisting that funds be provided as a match locally, but there's some little bit of scoring that can, like if you were able to, it would enhance the score a little bit, yeah.
Could in fact, other grant funds make up that match?
Yeah, I believe so, yeah. But they have to be shown that they're in place and you've got them, it's not a huge, huge part of the grant. So if you're unable to, well, we might lose a point, but it's not required.
We're swinging.
So essentially, there used to be four primary questions that determined the scoring of these grants, in addition to the bonus points, which are gone. But the four questions were, what is the need? Is the project feasible? What has been the level of community participation, and what will be the impact of the project? This time there's two questions. Mm-hmm. What is the need, and is the project feasible? And it's 65 points for those two questions. 40 points are all in the need. Are we able to describe the need for the project? Has there been housing, is there a waiting list? What is the condition of housing? What is the age of the housing? And things of that nature. And we were able to demonstrate that in the last grant application. I don't think we'll have a hard time demonstrating that for an upcoming application. Hayden Street project, what is the age of the water lines? What's the condition of the road surface? How is the drainage impacting area residents? And we're pretty good at demonstrating the need. And feasibility, if you have plans, design plans, it shows that it's feasible. So those are a few good projects, and I'm not asking for a decision tonight. I want to continue to work with the committee and see if we could flush these out and present them back to the board at a later date. Perhaps in early January would be a time to sort of nail down the projects that you'd like to seek. I want to take this time to thank the Community Development Advisory Committee for helping with this program and putting in the time.
Definitely. That shows. Thank you.
Thank you.
I'll need minutes for tonight, specifically regarding a community development strategy, and a copy of the sign-in sheet, and these get submitted with the application.
And if you have any issues that you want to see included in the minutes, drafts should probably be ready in about 2 weeks.
All right, great. If they could share them, and I'll have some comments.
Just reach out with an email requesting.
Again, thank you very much for seeing me tonight.
Thank you. It's our pleasure.
Thank you, everyone.
Item number 4, Community Compact.
Have you had a chance to?
I did have a chance to read it. My only question, from what I saw, it basically says to choose one item, and
you got a better one.
Well, education's at my heart. That was the first one on the list, but I saw that. Thank you, sir.
Thanks, Chris.
That I saw that you dragged down your list, and so yeah. Do we have to hit all of those talking points on that pull down menu?
I know Mary Lou was the one.
Did you? It's right there.
On this one?
See how these are all pull downs, and you actually pull down the human
resources.
Yeah,
Mary Lou had got all of this. Yeah, she got the human resources and the best practices.
So you understand signing on to this, we have to develop a plan for all this.
Yes.
It has to be checked, and we have to follow it. Not a bad thing. It's just it's a plan.
It focuses you.
Yeah, it focuses on
And you get some cash
but
to help
it has
you.
To. I think it was on to continue to the other page as well. No, it wasn't.
No, it doesn't. It's just here.
Yes, sir.
We understand.
I'm sorry. If
That's
it
okay.
pleases the board, there was one last piece that slipped my mind.
Oops.
Back in 1997, the town hired a consulting group, I think Stavros, to develop what you call an Americans with Disabilities Act transitional plan. Okay? And I know because I used part of that plan in an application years and years ago, but I only had an excerpt from it. Now this is important because the state is asking the town to have that plan should they want to pursue any funds related to like an ADA project, mm-hmm. like an elevator or a ramp.
Did you just request an excerpt or did you?
At that time, yeah.
So I'm assuming, and no
one seems to be able to find it. CMRPC does not have it. Right. PVPC does not have it. And we have not been able to locate it locally. Now, if you don't have it, unfortunately, that would set back any sort of timeline towards getting funds to address an elevator.
So, Linda, can you look into
okay,
what
so
we have for
what
fund?
Are we looking now for?
Americans with Disabilities
okay.
Act.
Okay.
Yep.
Transitional plan. It was done by Stavros.
In the 90s?
1997.
I have your a copy of the excerpt you're talking about, Cindy has.
Right.
1997 it was done?
Right. If you don't have it, you'll have to seek another one.
You're right.
Okay.
Yeah, Cindy was going to come up and look as well, but she...
I'm sorry, that slipped my mind, but if you could make sure those are in the minutes, okay?
So it's back. It was back in 1997. Okay.
Right.
All right.
Access Plus, Stavros. Center for Independent Living, I think, something like that.
All right.
Sorry.
Thank you, sir. So back, that's a good breaking point.
Okay.
Back to where we are. You guys want to run with this one. Do we want to address the other four potential above and the several below?
I'm saying take one and stick to it.
I think we should take one because this will be a lot of help for us trying to develop.
Well, all of these will be help for the town. So do we want to... box ourselves into just that, then this is a devil's advocate.
You can go back. It doesn't mean that you can't go back later and do others.
Right.
And I would say get your feet wet first.
Yeah, we would like to do this one because this would help us out a lot with our personnel handbook that we want to do.
And we're going
to
have conversations a little later on the very topic of human resources, so this is, to me, something very important.
I think it is, too. And the committee agreed with it, too.
Yeah. I'm not opposed to entering into the compact. So I'm going to entertain a motion to enter into community compact and leave it at that, and then we'll discuss that the selectmen will have to request which one we want to go, but we haven't developed anything.
Mm-hmm.
Do we want to show that we want to lean towards a human resource?
Lean towards that.
All right, so enter... into community compact with the subcategory of human resource, Linda?
Human resources, best practices.
Entertain said motion.
I'll make the motion.
I'll second it.
All right, so for discussion, through the reading, the plan has to be developed, the plan has to be submitted, and then we work with that.
And it takes quite a long time now because we're kind of like at the back end of the list of towns, and we don't sign up for, we actually have a time when we then can sign up, where we're actually just going through the motions of getting the paperwork in place now, and that's what this motion does, and then later on we get to actually do the signature of what we're going to do with the signature.
So we'll set up a meeting then with the personnel board? Because we said we'd help out with a lot of the paperwork and the application.
Yep. All right, any other discussion? Mm-hmm. Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Item number 5, appointments and resignations. I will entertain a motion with regret to approve Ms. Virchow's resignation with a letter of appreciation sent.
I'll make the motion.
I'll second it. Any discussion?
Any discussion?
Yeah, I'd just like to wish her good luck with all of her future endeavors, and we've enjoyed having her with us the last couple of years.
And that we won't let her write her own letter?
No.
but on that same token, back to the whole human resource, from an exit interview, communication and whatnot, do we have a practice or policy in place for an exit?
No.
Just so that we have it in place?
No, we don't.
Can we at least have...
You can discuss that with your community compact.
Oh, that's well down the road of having that, but I'm just saying with the current practices, we don't have a practice.
No.
And before Krista would go away, to have a conversation as to good news, bad news, and what we should take away from her time with us.
And you know, I appreciate all of that, and that's the real world, my world. Yeah. We're a small community, we're a small town. We listen. Well, I do. I listen to these people.
Mm-hmm.
I try to act right away. So to me, it's just redundant because we've taken it. And if they have issues, they usually want to come to us, and they do come to us.
Oh, and I'm not. It's just like my question of Carrie: of what should we be doing differently? Is the question I'm asking? It's not something that's.
And I've had those discussions with her since day one. So.
Well.
Yes, ma'am.
Steve, the personnel committee is also interested in possibly participating in exit interviews just to get a broader feel for what happens. We're not here day to day, but as a personnel committee, it would be advantageous to us to talk to employees as they're leaving and just get a feel for it.
So we have volunteers, if that would be appropriate.
You look like you're in deep thought.
I yield to the chairman of the personnel committee.
Yeah, we do. We've talked about it, and I think it would be a good idea if we did sit down, you know, with these people and, you know, find out maybe the reasons that they're leaving or if anything on our part, you know, one of the things that we can improve on.
So my argument, and again, devil's advocate, knee-jerk, if we have a selectman that's chairing the committee, isn't it just advantageous for that selectman to go report back to that committee?
Yes.
Yes.
I would hand that responsibility off in a heartbeat.
I would report back to the committee what we found out.
And I'm assuming that you're in the same boat as I am, because you're here as well, of what goes on in the building.
Yeah.
And if your committee has any questions, you should be able to answer them.
Yeah. It's really a one page, 3 or 4 questions, and documented, and you put it in a notebook, and you have it.
Yeah. And you put it in a personnel folder?
Yes, exactly.
Further discussion?
Yep.
Definitely warranted. We took a vote, right?
Yep.
No, we didn't take a vote.
All in favor? I want Karen back.
Yes, you do.
All in favor?
Aye.
That was the bad news. The good news, we have a individual that's requesting to be appointed to the CDBG block grant.
Great.
Entertain a motion to appoint Mr. Simpson to said committee.
I will make that motion.
I will second it.
Any discussion?
I will say that Mr. Simpson attended the meeting the other day and learned a bunch of stuff.
Good.
So good stuff. In fact, I couldn't make the meeting, so Bill attended.
What's that?
I couldn't make the meeting.
So do we want to take a vote? Do we take the vote?
We did not. I'm writing as we speak.
Oh, I'm sorry.
I was going to remind him that we...
No, we didn't have a signature, so I'm good. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye, thank you.
Al's back there.
Okay. What's that?
I was just looking.
Al snuck back into the room.
Yeah, he's back again.
Yep.
You're up, sir. Item number 6, land donation discussion. We have talked about this. An individual in town wants to donate a piece of land to the town. Ordinarily, I'm okay with that, obviously. What struck a chord with me on this one was that it's kind of muddied down with some legal issues that we would have to pay as a town to get a free and clear deed. We've had the discussion before that the town's not in the land business, the land owning business, especially at the expense of the town to make that deed free and clear. I've heard the argument of Al that it's just going to come back to us anyways and we're going to incur that expense. I guess I'm here to be swayed. I think I've said my opinion. Al, the floor is yours, sir.
Well, when this came up, the woman came in, does not want to pay taxes. The land is going to go. It's not a buildable lot according to one interpretation of the bylaws, which says if an abutter owns a non-conforming lot for X amount of time and doesn't do anything with it, it no longer is a buildable lot. So you've been paying for a half-acre lot and it's been averaging, well, I pulled the assessment history real quick, so it's a little spotty, but you can get the idea. Going back through, so the latest one I think is 43.9. Or did we drop down a little bit? But that's the assessed value of a non-buildable lot. So I would argue initially that she has way overpaid for years.
That's kind of outrageous.
Yeah, it's not right. Her husband passed away. She did what she thought was right by continuing to pay the tax bill. She now no longer wants to pay it. We're going to get it, whether we have to go through the whole tax title thing down the line. So I did a little investigation, found out what the problem was. Rather than pay KP to do all of that, I did it. And then someone said I could go there, so I went to KP, forwarded the info to them. They approved what I had already, rather than pay them to do all the research. The problem is that the actual parcel had the wrong description put with it, but the intent was for her to own that parcel. It always was, always will be. And a description of a piece of land down the street on the other side of the road, completely separate, was put on there. They agree. They're estimating maybe $500 to do the title piece on their side. In my mind, at this point, she has more than taking care of us over the years. And it seems to me that the easiest way for everybody to get out of this would be to continue through. And then once we've proved clear title, we would go to a town meeting in the spring to accept a donation if the townspeople want it.
I know there's been controversy with this property for years.
Mm-hmm.
I think it's...
This is it. This is the controversy.
Yeah, the abutter that owns the property now.
It went to that. If you read through the whole thing, it's in there. Land court.
Yeah.
The decision was in her favor. Mm-hmm. The person that sold the land to her, I went to him, talked to him. Everything is in there. I'm not trying to hide anything by not throwing names out, but it's all in there, and I don't want to.
Yeah.
Anybody that would like to come down to the office, love to have visitors. Mm-hmm. Come on, we're going to talk about the whole thing, but it's everybody is in agreement that what it was intended was for her and her husband to own the land. She is now, she's getting up there in age. She says, I don't want my kids to have to deal with this. I want to deal with it. I want it done. So she's not going to pay taxes. Tax bills are going to go out. She is not going to pay.
I'd almost make the recommendation this has to go to town for approval to accept.
Oh, absolutely.
Okay.
I believe it would be at the discretion of the town to accept it I don't even think it has to be a free and clear title. I think it could be pending in the motion to be free and clear.
If it doesn't, if we don't accept it and it does not, I mean, we've done a lot of due diligence at this point. If we prove, if we decide not to go forward with and clear the title on our own dime at this point, what I see happening is it's going to, whether we accept it or not, we're going to end up dealing with it.
Yeah.
And we're going to end up dealing with a property that we can't prove title on, and we're going to go through this whole thing again in 5 years.
So I would recommend that we put it on the town meeting with the caveat that if we approve it, then the town would incur the free and clear title, and it's up to the town if they want to do it.
Yeah.
So it's a kind of hurry up and wait situation.
Can I request that somebody from the board sends her a letter detailing that, because that's your thoughts on it? Is that fair for me to request that? I can get her address and everything if it's not in there.
I'd rather call her.
Oh, then call. I can get you the, yeah, whatever. I just think it should come from you folks, not me.
Yeah, I think we should vote.
Yeah.
This is our strategy. It's our intent to take it to town meeting for town approval.
Again, the estimate right now was $500 to finish this off. But if we, so that would be on hold until.
With the acceptance of the town.
Yep, just want to make sure that, because that would stop it right now.
You understand, thinking this as a taxpayer, not a board of selectmen, why would I want to pay $500 to a piece of property that we don't own? Granted, she's been paying outrageous taxes.
Yep.
That can be an argument, and my heart goes out to her, goes out to her whole family. That's absolutely ridiculous to pay that amount of money.
Yep.
But it's the town's $500 that we can't recoup.
In her, she has come in the past and argued and was not...
For an abatement.
But yeah, and it was not...
Approved.
It was not approved. It was actually, she wouldn't even go in the office. I had to meet with her out here. It was a... I don't know
situation.
What happened in the past. I don't want to point fingers at anybody. But I don't think this has been a smooth thing all the way through.
Again, from a taking perspective, this is the best route.
Yeah,
even though it's going to cost us $500, it's the best route.
But I agree. I think the money, we should get the approval of town meeting, and then we spend the money.
Sure.
All right, so I'll entertain a motion to place the issue on the town meeting warrant to accept property and then obtain clear title upon acceptance.
I will make that motion.
Second.
Any discussion?
No.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Can I just verify that if I get a phone number, somebody's going to reach out to her?
I'll call her.
Okay.
If you can just get me the information,
yep.
Just text it to me, name and phone number. You good with that, Ed?
Yeah, not a problem. Can I comment on something that came up earlier and I wasn't here?
Yeah.
You guys, I don't know what the discussion was like for Carrie, but I can tell you in going through the whole tax rate thing, she, kind of like me, is new to the town and the way things go. Anytime I needed any info from her, I had it immediately. I could not have asked for a better friend going through this whole thing. Really,
that's
I can't
nice
say enough good things about it.
Thank you very much. That's a nice compliment to us.
Thank you.
Yeah, no problem. It's always good to throw out the good stuff.
It is, isn't it? Unfortunately, we don't get many good things.
And also, I don't know if I could say while he is here, that Mr. Seary did have something to say also in his letter. Where is it here?
About Al?
About Al. He had something about Al. So let me see if I can find. Okay. And if you don't mind me reading it.
Not at all.
He said, that being said, I would also like to commend the assessors for hiring Al Jones as our assistant assessor. Al has also come forward and made an incredible amount of progress in that office in a short amount of time. Al has a ready smile and a pleasant demeanor for everyone and diligently follows up on everything. In short, we are very fortunate to have these two employees working for our town. So Al had a compliment too.
$20 went a long way.
I heard a rumor it was $100. So you're denying that? Should the minutes reflect that?
The heat's running right now.
All right. Item number 7, Route 9 sign discussion. Mm-hmm. Mr. Snyder requested this discussion. The floor is yours, sir.
Yes, Mr. Holcraft and I are at odds again. So with that, I asked Mr. Holcraft to remove my name from his sign. Mr. Holcraft has the right to have the sign. He's permitted to have the sign. He has a right from a perspective of First Amendment to say what he wishes to say. On the other hand, he is also a representative of the town. And given that he is a representative of the town, certain decorum is necessary. And I do not fully believe that naming names on the sign and suggesting that a particular selectman is lying or otherwise is appropriate behavior.
No, I agree with you.
And so given that, again, I've verbally asked Mr. Holcraft to remove my name from the sign. I now have a letter that I will hand to him before his leaving here tonight, and I would like the record show that I, in fact, handed a document to him suggesting that first, that a hostile work environment is a form of harassment, that under equal opportunity opportunity program, a hostile work environment is an action is actionable under EEO process when it is based on allegations of discrimination and reprisal. It is my intent to present this allegation of a hostile work environment to the town to conduct an expedited inquiry into the allegation to determine if a hostile work environment exists. I ask that all town employees who have been allegedly harassed provide the documentation to the town of their allegations. This request of an expedited inquiry does not preclude my or other town employees' right to file a complaint under a federal EEO complaint process. So that's your copy.
Do you have a copy for me, Clint?
Yes, I do.
Do you have a copy for each of
us? Yes, I do. What this letter...
Dave, come on.
Oh, that's...
Just making a statement.
It's not acceptable, Dave.
This is
a selectman's meeting.
It's right on... It's
can
exactly...
You, Dave, guys, please. Thank you. Dave, can you please place the trash bucket back? Thank you.
So what you have here, Steve, is a letter from me asking for an inquiry.
Do you have a copy for each of them?
Yes, I do.
Oh, good. Thank you.
And that's the copy of the letter that I just gave Mr. Holton.
Okay.
And Linda, this is your copy, but hang on a second.
Okay.
Oh, here it is. Letter, Steve's letter.
So,
letter of
so
the
for
facts.
Everybody here, this is the first time that I was handed to it, so I'm just going to read it, so if you could just bear with me.
Yeah.
Is Linda's letter the same, Clarence?
Yes. You have two packages.
Thank you.
So I ask the board to move forward with this inquiry.
So for discussion, I'll start the discussion. Clarence, first and foremost, I don't think the sign is appropriate. I'm sorry for you. But at the same time, I take a step back and I realize that Mr. Holcraft's yellow sign is Mr. Holcraft's yellow sign as a human being. And there's no labeling of Mr. Holcraft, chairman, and the advisory committee on that sign. I just don't see how they go hand in hand.
He is a town employee. Simply as that.
Well, he's a volunteer, just kind of like we are.
We are, under Mass State law, employees of the town. Right, wrong, or indifferent, that is the reality.
I personally don't see it as a hostile work environment. I know other people have had issues with it. Two people that I know of have issues with Mr. Holcraft on his personality and his way of getting things. I don't think he's really ever stepped over the line. I see them as two different items. I personally don't see it as a hostile work environment or harassment. Linda?
Well, I know we've gone over this for many, many years.
You have.
And I do apologize to the Clarence for this. I had talked to Mr. Holcraft about this just the other day. We had a discussion about if he wants to put things up there, maybe he shouldn't name the person. He should just, if he has comments, leave the person's name out of it and not put it up. And he says, no, he wouldn't do that.
And that's what he told me.
And I don't, on this hostile work environment, I mean, I don't think that there's people. I mean, I know there's other people in the past that he's done it to. But I don't know if I really call it a hostile work environment.
I would.
Thank you, everyone.
Okay.
You're welcome.
Okay.
Yes. Hear us.
I've heard you, and I'd ask you to hear me as well.
Can I speak?
Most certainly, Kermit.
Yeah.
I think Holcraft, if you disagree with Dave Holcraft, he put something up on the sign. He said he's telling the truth. I'm sure. In his opinion, Clarence, Mr. Snyder, has not said the truth. I'm sure in some instances, maybe you or Linda have not said the truth. Why isn't your name up there? Why isn't Linda's name up there?
That's a question of Mr.
Holcraft. That is because we have, Mr. Holcraft and myself, have had disagreements on things.
And I have as well.
And I know.
Why isn't your name up there?
I know your name.
He disagreed with me.
I know your name is up there as well.
He said I was goose stepping around town. Yeah, that's not the truth. I was not goose stepping.
But we had that conversation as well privately, correct?
Pardon?
You and I had that conversation privately. Well, my opinion of it.
Okay. I don't recall that.
You called me. Yeah.
Like, oh, yes. Yeah. Well, that's not, he called me more than goose stepping.
No, you and I, you called me after it came up on the side.
Yes, but it was not, he didn't call me Gustav, he called me a Nazi.
Yeah. And you know I disagree with that.
And I retorted it. Yeah. And I must say, I apologize for calling him something I shouldn't have after that. But Dave, if he doesn't like her, Chafee, it's her. But if it's somebody that he doesn't like, he puts up on the side. That, to me, is a form of harassment.
And that's where it gets into a civil matter where Mr. Eaton would sue Mr. Holcraft civilly.
No.
Yes.
No. You have an opportunity, Steve, as the chairman of the Board of Selectmen, to have an inquiry. I would highly recommend that this to Couple and Page and have them do the investigation.
That was my next question, is who would do...
Because we do not have an HR function in this town to go through this matter or other similar matters. You would turn under the personnel board, you would charge the personnel board with a requirement to go to Couple and Page and have them do an inquiry. What I also am stating in that last paragraph is that should you choose not to, I have my rights to go to EEO straight ahead.
Mm-hmm.
What I'm asking you to do is so have Copeland and Page do the inquiry.
Have you reached out to KP?
No.
I don't just need
I don't think they do things like that.
Well, don't we have human resources with them? I thought we did.
You're paying for it.
Yeah, we're paying for it.
We're not under that contract anymore.
Oh, we're not.
No, we haven't been for years.
You need an expert in the field of human resources.
What they're going to do is give us an opinion.
That's correct.
Well, I think
they're not going to do an investigation. They're going to base an opinion on case law.
Yes.
Yeah.
And I want you to have that opinion.
I agree. I feel that this should be turned over to Copeland.
I'm not opposed to having KMP rule on it.
Yeah, I think you need to do the inquiry.
We need to do that.
Based on the inquiry, we'll have a conversation.
But I would ask that you would reach out to Attorney Mendazzo and request the investigation, but have her contact me prior to make sure that we're going down the same road and we're not going off on a tangent.
Because I'm involved, I should be recusing myself of this, and I would then, and again, I would highly recommend, to turn, and again, Linda, pardon me, but I would turn it to the personnel board to have be the intermediary, not me.
This is a Board of Selectmen's issue. It's not the, this is a Board of Selectmen's issue.
What I'm saying is the chairman of the personnel committee is a select person. I'm suggesting that Linda be the intermediary, not me.
Did you want to contact Michelle?
I will contact Michelle, and I can scan all of this in, and I'll send it to her. We had a question from...
Yeah, I just need to write this down.
Okay, I'm Carrie. I will... do you still want me to have her get in touch with you, too?
No, I just wanted... If Clarence was going to... And I respect you staying out of it.
I will have...
I want an independent investigation.
Yeah.
They make a decision. Yeah. That information gets to be promoted or promulgate it to everyone, and we understand where we stand.
So you want an investigation done, huh?
Right. Okay. And all I'm saying is, in the meantime, should further activities or actions happen, I can go separately directly to both state or federal EEO.
And that's your right.
That's the document.
So, do you want to read the motion before you comment, or...
I'm sorry?
No. Did you want me to read the motion before you made a comment? You wanted to comment?
I just wanted to comment.
No, my eyes over here. She doesn't, I guess. All right. No. So I will entertain a motion for Ms. Lincoln to contact KP for a decision on a hostile work environment in regards to Mr. Holcraft.
I'll make that motion.
And I'm not seconding.
I will second.
Thank you.
Any discussion? Karen?
I just wanted to make mention, because of the way the conversation was going, I have performed many HR duties, and these complaints included, and I do believe that you're on the right path, Clarence. You have to recuse yourself, and it should go through the personnel board. And I'm glad you decided to go with an investigation, because had you not, you would have opened yourself up to some huge liability by refusing to do an investigation on a formal complaint. Just so that you're aware in the state, that is that is the way that things need to go.
Okay.
Any further discussion?
No. I'll comment, Steve.
I'll accept that. You keep it appropriate, though, okay?
Every time I speak, it's appropriate.
Well, the trash can was not appropriate.
Yeah. That's fine. I made a statement. That's fine. First of all, I'm not a town employee. I've taken no funds or no monies from this town, so I'm not a town employee. I'm a volunteer, 100% volunteer. I have not taken any pay from the planning board, so I'm not an employee. So you can't say that. You can go to the personnel board, you can do anything you want. As far as putting names up, that's correct. I put people's names up. People go on the computers, and they do all sorts of stuff on the computers. Same thing when the citizen put all that propaganda up there. Same thing. I'm using this billboard. You guys use a computer, all that crap behind the scenes, so knows there's no difference. You got nothing. I haven't slandered you. In my opinion, as you always say, where you're packed, what I have on the sign is true, and I'm sticking to it. So
with
has nothing to do with the advisory board, zero, zippo.
With that, Clarence, and again, I sympathize, because nobody wants to be ridiculed in public.
Mm-hmm.
I've had people in this room, which technically in your definition of public employees, town employees, rip me apart on Facebook. And it hurts.
Oh, absolutely.
Of course it does.
You don't pursue it, they're lies, it's wrong.
This is the larger opportunity that we have, as to what is decorum within the town.
And I would agree.
And so...
But I just want to show that that's the path that I took, I just swallowed it and...
Again, this is a lesson for all of us.
Mm-hmm. Yes, it is.
Maybe the larger thing here is that I teach Sunday school, and 8 of my students go to that school, and they see that. Now, how am I, once we get through the pageant and everything else, how am I to explain it to the young people that I've taught church school for 30 years?
Did you want my suggestion, or was it rhetorical?
Well, yeah, I'd ask you.
In a church aspect, that's the Lord teaches you to turn the other cheek.
Oh, and I certainly have.
But that's the lesson you want to teach to your students.
Oh, yeah. We talk about inviting businesses to town. We talk about, we can't have the slander, right, Steve? Or libel in your case.
But that has to be proven.
Just the inference. And again, now we have an expert in ages. Thank you for...
From
Carrie speaking up. That we have some expertise that are available to us. We've got to educate folks in town of what is proper behavior. And this may give us a vehicle. And it may not, but it's worth having a conversation.
I'm not saying that you have a case or not. My comment was simply that you have made a formal complaint, and there is a step to follow by the law. That's all I'm saying. It wouldn't be up to me to decide one way or the other.
And my argument to that is exactly what Mr. Holcraft and I didn't choreograph. People believe that, you know, Dave and I are besties, and we've had it out. We've had some really heated conversations.
Yep.
I don't believe he's a town employee.
I know I'm not. I've been through this before. We've been going through this sign for 10 years. Give up.
But it's
tell
it's
the
not,
truth
but it,
when you
but
come
it,
in town. You're a town official, Clarence. Am I right? You were elected. I have the right to criticize you up and down all day long, and you can't say nothing. Look what they do to Mr. Trump. Horrible what they do to him. What are you going to do, run after him, go after all the people that put him down?
David,
you're an elected official, and that goes with the territory.
But we're on two different roads here. We got
okay.
The yellow sign.
I'm not a town employee then.
And that's where we're going to get the K&P.
I'm not a town employee.
Well, you're elected to the planning board.
And you're further
that does not make me a town employee because
so
I'm not taking any money.
We're going in a circle that's not going to be resolved tonight. That's why we have the motion
on
the floor.
I'm up here doing my spiel.
Anything else?
He did his spiel, so I have the right to do mine.
Anything else?
So I'm not a town employee. So the best advice I can give you, Clarence, is you want to stay up the sign, tell the truth.
Okay? Suggesting that the highway department did a good job in opening Dunbrook, David, is not lying.
We all complimented them the good job that they
what
did.
What does that have to do with what we're talking about?
What you told me verbally.
That
was
has
the
nothing
reason
to do with that. Has nothing to do
that
with
was
the sign.
Lie that
now
I
there you go again. You're on a spin again. You're taking the conversation somewhere
Mr.
else.
Mr. Chairman, I turn to you.
This isn't a productive conversation. So we do have a motion. Anything else to say, Mr. Holcraft?
No, it's good.
All right. Any further discussion?
I agree with Mr. Snyder on the fact, you know, he teaches, like you said, CCD. We call it, that's what the Catholics call
it.
It
used to be, yes.
And we teach that to the children, and I mean, you know, they have to believe in the person that's teaching them about their religion, and it's kind of hard to for him to explain why he's being called, you know, a liar on these signs.
I hate to laugh, Clarence, but there's no doubt in my mind that the kids, the six kids, I think, believe you said, that see that sign, that come to you, absolutely adore you, and no black letter on a yellow sign is going to change that. So,
but still, it puts it in their mind, you know, what is he teaching? You know, he's teaching me the rights, he's teaching me about God, and he's being called a liar.
And I don't agree with the kids.
And then it's his grandson's even up there at the school, too. So.
No, they're just going to get open to the real world even quicker, that's all.
No, I think it's a little young to be open to the world.
Anything else?
You had some on the audience.
So,
Peter?
Well, Mr. Snyder tried to address it, and Mr. Holcraft disputed it. It would be appropriate to ask what the lie allegedly was.
I'm not going to entertain that conversation.
Okay.
that's between them two.
Interesting, Mr. Glenn seemed to think he knew what it was.
Not a productive conversation in this venue.
Not at this time.
Any further discussion? All in favor?
All right, thank you.
Thank you. Are you going to recuse yourself from this?
Yes.
From the vote?
Yeah.
Thank you. Number eight, the Mack truck. There was a request, I believe it was Friday night. Highway Department would like to put the 1980 Mack truck and spare engine into surplus, or basically give it away, dispose of it. I sent out an email requesting, did he send out a request for other departments? It doesn't really fit within the policy.
Well, you put a $500, he'd like to get $500 for it if he can.
But no other departments are requesting it?
Not that I, well, this well, that,
that's, part, that's we, part of the policy is to ask for other departments. I'm assuming.
They haven't yet, I don't think. They just wanted us to.
But I'm assuming that no other department really wants it?
I would.
Think not?
Yeah. No, really, yeah. What can you do with it?
I think it's scrap, but. Yeah, if you can get $500 for it, great.
They wanted to put it all around. What do they call it?
Yeah, he's a list.
Yeah.
It's a state thing.
Mural list? Yeah.
I'm just writing a motion, so bear with me.
If you'd like, I would be more than happy, Steve. I could do minutes, you know.
I didn't think tonight was going to be that complicated. I didn't think you liked to do them.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't think you liked to do them.
I've been doing them for years, so if you'd like, any time.
Hopefully she'll be back next meeting. All right, so I'll entertain a motion to request the Highway Department to contact all departments for the disposal, and then if there is no interest, to place on municipal.
Yeah.
Do I have a motion?
I'll make the motion.
Second.
Any discussion?
No.
Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Item nine. Again, it's another issue. I don't think this is an issue.
Sorry, I missed that.
Siri, I don't think that this is an issue. There's a request that the telephone poles down at the campground are not being used, and there is a potential desire for Wagon Wheel to receive them. I don't believe they hold any value whatsoever to the town, so we really don't even fall into a policy. I think they're trash. I don't even think we need a motion, but if you guys want to make a motion.
Mm-hmm. Yield to you.
Yeah.
Kermit's right here. You can tell him to get rid of them.
What do you feel comfortable with?
It would cost us money to get rid of them.
So I'm just going to let the minutes reflect that discussion. Discussion led to the decision that it's trash. Are we good? And then you can do whatever you want with them. So it doesn't fall within our purview or desire to do anything.
What do Wagon Wheel want to do? Can they use them?
They can use them. Have at it.
There's no value to it.
No, let them
right. It's just one more thing.
There's an expense to us to get it.
Yeah. Dave?
Yeah, how many telephone poles are there?
Two.
Two.
Two?
And it just adds to the £1 million that we've already gotten rid of. We don't do it.
Well, if Wagon Wheel doesn't take them, I'll take them. They can have them.
All right, so I'm going to let the minutes reflect that the board decided there's no value for the poles, and it's at the discretion of the Highway Department to dispose. Mm-hmm. Are we good with that, Kermit?
I'm fine with it.
You have the scrambled eggs on in regards to that issue. Any other discussion?
Yeah, just to follow up on that. So where we are with the campground is that you signed the contract, contracts were mailed back to the state. We should be receiving our signed copy back, I'm hopeful, of this week. We had a bid review. We did receive three bids.
Yeah.
We had a bid review. We made a recommendation. The state actually gets to decide whether that recommendation is correct or not. And with that, we then can move forward with the hiring of the archaeologist. I would expect that early January we would be doing that. Again,
That was all in the email you sent.
Yes, I just wanted for the folks here. And then the second piece to it is a calculation that Kermit did do of the work that we've done over this last year, really, to clean up the place. And that 1 million+ pounds of trash, metals, and the rest, concrete, have been removed from the site. And so I, again, look to the volunteers and thank the volunteers for all of their efforts to clean up the site.
With that, Mr. Eaton had contacted me, and forgive me if I was out of place for giving him permission to, it's about $1,000 that they're going to go over for that. I gave him permission to go ahead because I think it's advantageous for the town. And if Kerry doesn't disagree, we can hold over that cost and deal with it at the end of the year.
Town meeting or whatever. We also had the thousand.
Special town meeting.
And I let Kermit know as well, we had $1,000 donated to us from the community club. So there's $1,000 there too if we have to use it. But yes, better if we can take advantage of the town.
Mm. Well, that's not the way to phrase it, take advantage.
No, I know. But,
but I see where you're going with it.
All right. Thank you.
Any other comments? And I thank everybody that's down there.
Yeah.
It's looks well, great.
Let me say this. The highway department and Bruce Clark did a tremendous job. Pulled 1 million pounds of debris out of that property at a modest cost to the town. And we did go over that budget a little bit, but we ended up with three dumpsters of in-ground pressure-treated timbers that we didn't anticipate.
There's just stuff everywhere.
Yeah, and so that put us over the top. But the space looks clear. There's two
That's
buildings,
good.
Very solid buildings that are there. The ground is level, and it's a good opportunity for them to do their archaeological work.
100% better.
And it looks like a park. And,
oh, that's
and
that's
again,
good.
I can't say enough about what the highway department and Bruce Clark
I'd like to thank them too for all the work they've done.
And the fact that nuisance of the swimming pool is
gone.
Not just distraction or nuisance, just liability.
Absolutely. Yeah. So one thing that they did do is that we've talked about this egress as far as another way to access Pine Lane. And so the guys have marked out what we would want for a future access.
Mm-hmm.
Between Hobbs and Pine through the property, so that as they do the dig or do the survey that they're going to do, to look to that area to make sure that we're safe in making that an access out into the future if we choose to do that.
Where were they talking about the access?
Make it a horseshoe from where the swimming pool is to Pine Lane and from Hobbs to where the swimming pool was.
I'm not a fan of allowing anybody on that property. I think it should be just sectioned off as it is. And
no, but you really need it.
It would be an emergency roadway only in case of there's an emergency, because that's a dead end street.
And it's,
it would not be open to the public. It would be a closed gate.
Before I saw it, I'd have to see a layout.
Again, we laid it out, but again, as we get into this thing in the spring and we figure out what we're doing, it's just to help us do a better job, that's all.
Because a sacred burial ground doesn't deserve to have a road blazing down the middle of it.
The other piece to it is that in proximity to the building that's being retained, it might be a visitor center or something like that in the future as well.
And that's where the plan, and I'm not totally shut off.
But we've needed an access down there for years, because growing up, you know, down there and just being, I remember going to school with a school bus. I mean, a school bus will take over the whole street down there. And if an emergency happens, nobody can get by or do anything.
No, that's why every lake road has a dead end, and the kids come up and meet the bus, and we can go over this all night, but we'll cross the bridge when we get to
something.
It.
Progress.
100%. And again, thank you to everybody involved. 10 other not usually wanting to take motions under other, but we're requested to allow the chair to sign the Commonwealth of Massachusetts contract to authorize signature listing. I will entertain a motion to allow chair to do so.
I'll make the motion.
Second.
I can sign this later. Other as well, I have reached out to a mason that is interested in the new construction of the door, the handicap door.
Oh, great.
He did, I think it was, I think he quoted me $2,450. He did it verbally, asked him to put it into writing.
Mm-hmm.
Not too many masons want to touch it, so I think we fall within our going out to bid for it, so I think we're good. We did our due diligence. Contacted Tantas. We're obviously back to the winter break. It's going to be pushed out, and the kids probably don't want to keep that door open, so it might be a spring thing. But it is, I have been working on it, and it is going forward.
So the only other thought is that we have a town employee that drives one of the plows, and again, the name escapes me at the moment, but he's also a retired carpenter.
Oh, yes, Steve Budnick.
Thank you.
Yeah, Bruce had told me to about
Steve. He's retired?
Yeah, from the carpentry side of things, so yeah. He's available.
I saw him down at Howell Lumber a couple months ago.
Well,
maybe he's just shooting the crook. Yeah.
Maybe, but I'm just thinking, Steve, back to your plans and the work poking away at this. I mean, he's an available resource.
Wouldn't push anybody away.
Yeah, and he'd be, Bruce had mentioned him to me a while back, and he said Steve would probably be willing to come up and do the work for us.
Any volunteer is a good volunteer.
Yep.
Especially a credible volunteer.
Yes, so I pass that to you.
Yeah, definitely. Any other?
Well, the only other I would like to do is wish good wishes to Karen. She hasn't been with us for a few weeks, and we hope she gets back here because she's got some... She's got minutes, but she's got some pretty big shoes to follow because I try to come up as much as I can and keep track of things.
It does prove that she's an asset, and we miss her.
I know she's been keeping up with the emails at home, and she knows what's going on.
100%. Up at night as well. I get response. I only return emails at night.
I know.
Not meeting before Christmas. I'd like to wish everybody a Merry Christmas, Happy New Year, and a Hanukkah.
Happy Hanukkah.
Hanukkah. Yeah. I'm not Jewish, so I apologize. Anything else?
No.
It's a good season this year, huh? It's been warm. It's going to get cold Friday, and Christmas is coming in 12 days. It's a good time of the year. Entertain a motion to adjourn.
I'll make that motion.
Second.
Any discussion? Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Thank you, everyone.